Welcome to the next installment in the series of videos on coordinate systems. This video is going to cover township and range, otherwise known as a public land survey system. This really isn't a coordinate system in the sense we've been talking about. We don't have true XY coordinates. This is basically a land management, land division system, and it basically helps us locate areas rather than individual points like we used UTM, geographic coordinates, and state plane. The public land survey system, interestingly enough, was developed by Thomas Jefferson. It was codified in 1784, so it's been around quite a long time. The Bureau of Land Management is charged with handling and managing this land survey system. It's used for helping map federal lands and tribal lands, all public lands in the domain, and we're going to go over this map here in a minute, are also managed using the public land survey system. As you can see on this map, that not every state is covered by the public land survey system. There's some states in the south, most of the eastern seaboard, basically north of the Ohio River for the most part. Some states east of the Mississippi don't have the public land survey system. Once you cross the Mississippi, most every state with the exception of Texas is part of the public land survey system. Most of the states that are in white here are part of, we're basically subdivided. The land was basically organized, or sort of not really organized all that well, using a system called meets and bounds. And I might shoot another video to cover the meets and bounds system, and also just a plain rectangular survey, and plain rectangular surveys are pretty frequently used, particularly in archaeology. Meets and bounds is not used anymore, thank goodness. There's 37 named meridians, so you'll notice that many of these states are divided by baselines, and then we have meridians that run north-south. There's 37 named meridians, and then we have these baselines, which are numbered by, like, this is what was created in 1855. There's one, the Ute baseline in 1880. The in 1875. The map we're going to be using, the baseline was 1855, and we're going to be working off the meridian, the Salt Lake Meridian. So you want this is all important to know in order to locate where you are within the public land survey system. So the way this survey system works, I'm going to use this figure here. So we have a principal meridian, and maybe I'll draw this out on my board like I like to do. And my phone's gonna move around here as I draw. So the idea is we have a principal meridian, and we have established some type of a survey line, a baseline. So this is my principal meridian, and this is my baseline. And I'm going to put here's east and west, and then this would be north, and here's south. Okay, now what I'm going to try to make this as rectangular as possible, but remember I'm drawing this freehand, so I'm not going to go too crazy here. But so these are equally spaced, right? I know they don't look like it, but that's just bear with me as I draw these out. So each one of these lines is 6 miles apart. And then I'm going to draw some okay, there we go. These are my township lines. And the first ones that I drew are my range lines. So let me so this each one of these is called a township, so this is my township grid. But make sure this is in the frame. Okay. So the way we do these is each, so we have a, so these are my townships, and these are my ranges. I'm gonna just do range here. Okay. I probably should have used another color because here's my principal meridian up here. Okay. So, and here's my principal meridian down here. Just gonna note that, and there's my baseline. Just to kind of keep my own frame of reference here as I do this. Okay, so I'm just gonna make some notations here. So here's 1, 2, 3, and here's 1 south, 2 south, 3 south. So here's 1 east, 2 east, 3 east, and here's 1 west, 2 west, and 3 west. Okay, so the way this works is I'm gonna fill in a little bit of some of this grid here with some information. So I'm gonna go up one. This is Township 1 North, Range 1 East, right? Because I've gone one up and one over. So here is Township 2 North because I've gone up 2 on the second row. And this is Range 2 East. And I'm not going to fill all this in, but this is Township 3 North, Range 3 East. So let's work the other way just so we know how we're going here. So this is going to be Township. I got a little bit of glare. I'm having problems with glare. So this is Township 1 South, Range 1 West. This is Township 2 South, Range 2 West. And this is Township 3 South, Range 3 West. Okay, so now we've identified a few, six townships on our township grid. So now you could probably go through and figure out how you mark up the rest of these and fill out the rest of the townships. Because I've given you enough here to work off of. Now, one of the things that I do need to note is these principal meridians, they're called named meridians. Why are they called named meridians? Because they have a name. Named meridians. Okay, so the map we're going to be working off of is called Flaming Gorge. Utah. So we have Flaming Gorge, and so I had to basically look this up and figure out where Flaming Gorge is. So if we look at our locator map, we know this quadrangle is in nearly the far. See if I can get this thing to focus. It has a hard time focusing because of the mylar on top of there. The cloudiness of the mylar kind of interferes the autofocus of the camera, but we can tell we're in the upper right corner, right near the border with Wyoming. Okay, and in fact, when we look at the name, this is the Flaming Gorge, Utah, Wyoming map. So this is the first time we've seen one of those on a map that we've examined in this video series. So I can tell we're way up here. So when I look at my principal meridian and my baseline locator map, we're like right up in this area right here. So I'm gonna use that information here in a little bit to check myself as to where I am on my map, because we're gonna look at the township and range notations on this USGS map here in a minute. So to take this forward, each one of these is a township, right? So I'm going to pull this one out because it's convenient for me to draw an arrow. So I'm going to bring this out, and we're going to look at this township. Good. I drew a pretty good square there. Okay. So this is Township. This is Township 3 North, Range 3 East. That's the township we're going to be looking at. So I'm going to try to carefully do this There's one there, there, and there, and then there, and there. And then I'm going to make a halfway mark there, and one there, and one there, and then split that up. And then I'm going to do the same thing over here, split that line in half, make those into thirds, and then make that into thirds, and this one, and that one, and that one, and that one. Okay, so here's, and you'll see why I've done that here in a second, because we're going to subdivide this township into sections. I'm going to connect these lines, and I'm going to connect these lines, kind of looks like squiggle vision a little bit, but I'm holding a camera and drawing at the same time. Okay, so here's our township. Now each one of these squares is a mile, so from here to this point is a mile, and that's a mile, and that's a mile. So we've got six squares along the bottom of this township, and so this is a 6 mile by 6 mile township. Okay, so this is 36 square miles. So pretty easy so far, right? Sort of makes sense. This is how we're going to subdivide our landscape. We've just imposed this rectangle or square on our landscape, and now we're going to divide it into even smaller squares, right? So these are numbered, actually. So we have in this one particular township, we've got 36 squares starting in the northeast corner and proceeding west. 5, 6, and then we're going to come down and do 7, 8. 9, 10, 11, 12, and I'm not going to do, so we'll just, there's 13, here's 24, here's 25, and then this one's 36, right? Because it's going to go 12, 13, come back, go this way, drop down, and go that way, drop down, and go that way, and then this way. So we'll end up with 36 right there, right? Okay. So each one of these is a square mile. Now, let's see if I can find some space. I'm going to erase something, so I'm going to pause. Okay, so I've got my township. I have my sections within my township numbered. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull one of these out. I'm going to pull out section 36, and we're going to look at this. So let's draw myself a square. I'm going to subdivide my square. Okay, so that's supposed to be equal. I know it kind of looks a little not like they're equal, but let's, for all intents and purposes, these are the same. This is section 36. Okay, so if we know that this is a mile, right? We know from that's a mile. 1 mile. And we know this is a mile. Make sure I have this into the frame. Okay, so we have 1 square mile. 1 mile square. Okay, so because we're talking about areas here and we're talking about land subdivision, so now we know that there's 1 square mile on this. We know how many feet are in a mile. There's 5,280 feet in a mile, right? We also know that inside this area, this is also 640 acres. So this 1 square mile is also 640 acres. So we can do a lot of different kind of things now, because if we quarter this up, what's 640 divided by 4? Well, that's got to be a 16, right? Or 160 acres. So each one of these smaller squares is 160 acres. Now I'm going to erase one of those. I should have left it blank so I could work. I'm going to take that one out. okay, because what I want to do is I want to subdivide this one. Okay, so now I've subdivided that one. So if this is 160 acres, and we're going to quarter that, right? So each one of these has to be 40 acres. And then if I quarter this one, each one of these has to be 10, right? And then if I quarter this, each one of these has to be 2.5 acres. Okay, good. So the other thing we have going on here is not only can we figure out how many acres are here, but we also have to have some type of a system set up so we can identify where we are within a section. Okay. And the way we do that is we're going to go ahead and say this is north and south and west and east. So we're just going to keep with that same structure. Well, this is the northwest quarter. This is a northwest one quarter of section 36, right? So if that's the northwest one quarter, then this must be the southwest one quarter of 36. This is the southeast one quarter of 36. So that would be the northeast, right? But we can even get even more, we can even get more detailed than that, because this is the northwest corner. This is the northwest one quarter, and this is the northeast, right, one quarter. So if I want to figure out where that one's at, so you basically you start at the smallest and you work towards the largest. So if this is the northwest one quarter, well, so this is the northwest. Just kind of follow me here. So this is the northwest one quarter of the northeast. See, this is the northeast one quarter, and this is the northeast one quarter, right? And so here, let me see if I can write this out somewhere on some. Let me find some space. So, let's say we're looking at this one right here. I'm going to shade it. Okay, so I shaded it. Okay, so this is the northwest one quarter. This is the northwest one quarter of the northeast one quarter, right? Of the northeast one quarter of section 36. Of township 3 north, range 3 east. I'm going to put a comma in here so I can keep my stuff straight. Right? And there we go. So we know exactly where this is now with this entire section, because we're in range 3 east, township 3 north, section 36, the northeast quarter, the northeast quarter, the northwest one quarter. And so we know that's 10 acres, so I'm going to put 10 acres, more or less. And there's one bit of information that I'm missing from this, because I don't really have it, because I've contrived this. So these are named meridians. So if we look at this map, I'm going to turn it sideways so we can see. But here's the Gila and Salt River meridian, the Salt Lake, the New Mexico meridian, the Black Hills meridian, there's a Wind River meridian, there's all these meridians, right? Boise, Principal, the Indian, the Sixth, okay? Well, I contrived mine, so I'm just going to call it the Busby meridian. And so basically the part that I left off here is right after this, right here, what I should have said is the Busby meridian. Ten acres more or less. So that tells me all the information that I need to identify that parcel on the landscape right there. So I'm going to get away from this example. We're going to go over here and look at this map. Okay, now we're back to looking at the Flaming Gorge, Utah, Wyoming map, the one on the 24,000 scale. We're going to go through and look at this information derived from photogrammetric methods, from aerial photographs taken in 1950, field checked in 52, revised in 1966, field checked in 1966. It's a polyconic projection based on the 1927 North American datum. There's a 10,000 foot grid based on the Utah state plane coordinates and north zone. There's a 1,000 meter UTM grid, ticks, no UTM grid. We're in zone 12. Here's our declination diagram. So we can see here's true north, grid north, and magnetic north. So right now there's about 15 and a half degrees pointing towards magnetic north. When this map was created, see, that's the thing, is like this map was created in 1966. Magnetic north is no longer in the same place because it drifts as the character of the our magnetic poles change. The contour interval on this map is 40 feet, and this is based on the National Geodetic Vertical Datum of 1929. So just some information there that you might want to be aware of. So if we look closely at this map, we can see some red lines. These are the section lines. Whoops. These are the section lines that I was building on my example earlier. So here's section 8, here's section 7, we're gonna see 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, here's 1. So we're at the top part. Here's the top, the northeast corner of a section. And so we know, for example, of our township. And so we know we've got a good township on here. So here's 1 to 6. And we're going to miss some stuff down here because the lands got kind of rugged and whatnot. But here's 19, 20, 21, 22. And then everything else is just kind of, we've kind of lost it off the map. Not some of these things are not complete on the map. But we've got enough information to work with here. So we know that here's a township that more or less that's been defined by this air by this grid. Noted along the side, we have our township and range notation. So we're at township 2 north. Because here's 1, we know that we should have another township above us, and there's the township notation for that. So there's township 3 above us. We're in township 2. Down to someplace down here. Like I said, it kind of falls apart on this particular part of the map. It does, we have another township to the west we can see, because here's township 2 north again. And here's the northeast section. And here's 1, 12, 13, 24, 25. So 36 would be down here. We can also go down here to the bottom, so we know we are at range 20 east. So we are a fair number of townships east of our baseline, right? We're 20 townships east of our baseline. Here's range 21 east, and that's as far as we're going to get because it falls off the map at that point. That we are north of our baseline because we have a township. We're township 2 north. We're two townships north of our baseline. And when we look at the notation at the bottom of our map, we know we're 20 townships east of our principal meridian. Now, when we go through and create the track description here, which I'll go over here in a minute, we're going to need to know what principal meridian we're based off of. So that's where this map that I showed you earlier comes in. And I'm going to lay this down here beside our locator map. So here's Utah and Utah. Let's wait for this thing to focus a little bit. Like I said, it has a hard time with this Mylar focusing on it. So we know we're really close to the corner up here. My dot's probably off a little bit too. I mean, need to be a little bit east. But the idea is we know we have this 1855 baseline. which is makes sense because when we go over here and look at our townships, we're very close to our baseline because we're only two townships north. So I'm going to go over here and be, I know, I feel confident about that because I know from our map, our locator map, that I should feel like I'm above the baseline. Also, if I look at my range, I'm 20 townships east of my principal meridian. Here's my principal meridian in Salt Lake, and I'm just going to go ahead and say yes, I feel pretty confident that I'm 20 townships east of my principal meridian here too, and my principal meridian is named Salt Lake, so that's my named meridian. Okay, so I feel confident that I know where I'm at, and all my stuff is lining up where I think it should line up because I am using my reference information to corroborate the information on my map. So now let's just kind of go through and do an exercise like what we did earlier, but we're just going to draw on top of this map, sort of. Okay, so we've got a section right here. Make sure I can keep myself in focus. Okay, so there's section 4. Now I'm going to go through and I'm going to kind of break this section up just like I did earlier on my example. Usually those labels are right in the center of the section, but as you can see here, for 21, it's clearly towards the top. 20 is clearly towards the top, you know, so it doesn't always hold true, so you have to watch it, but I feel pretty confident that 4 is near the center of this grid. So we know that this is a mile, and we know this is a mile, and we know this is a mile, and we know that that is a mile. Okay, so we've got 1 square mile from here. So it's 1 mile by 1 mile, right? And it's one, I should write that over here, 1 mile square. So just forget that for a second. And we'll just do this and that. Good. Okay, so we know a square mile is equal to 2,580 feet. And I like to hold on to that. We also know that inside a square mile is 640 acres. So, for example, if we consider both of these together, if this whole thing is 640, then half is 320, right? And so this is 160. And then if I go up here and subdivide this even more, let's just leave it like that. So if this is 160, then half of this must be 80 acres. And then I'm going to divide that, so that must be 40 acres. And that's 20. Right? And that's 10. All right. So we have all this broken up. Pretty easy, pretty straightforward, actually. It's kind of fun, actually, once you get started and you realize how everything works. Now you can start making measurements, and you know how many acres are out there. And now we can start looking at building the kind of a legal description. So let me shade this in blue. Right? I'm going to shade that in blue. Had an exploding blue pen. So this is the southeast quarter. The southeast one quarter, right? This is the southeast one quarter this is the northwest quarter. Let's see, southeast, northwest, northwest. We're done, because there's only three steps there. Of section 4, And this is Township 2 North. Range, what did we say this range was? This is range 21 East. Of the name of this meridian was the Salt Lake, of the Salt Lake Meridian. And we know that's 10 acres. More or less. All right. So that is what your land description should read like. If it doesn't read like that, then you got a problem. You've got to have all this information. You've got to be able to track it back. Northwest corner, southeast one quarter, southeast one quarter. You got to have the number of acres, got to have the township, got to have the range, and you have to have the named meridian. Anything shy of that, and you're missing something. So it's pretty easy once you figure out where things are. So, you know, people will say, so, you know, what might happen is when you're looking at, say, a legal description for, here's this thing called Antelope Flat Development, right? So if you had to pull a record or a deed on that, you may see something that says the Antelope Flat Development. It's going to give you a section number. It may tell you, like, if we go through and carve this section up, I'm just going to do a really fast division here. Here's 27, and do that, and something like that. So this is the northwest, this is southwest, northeast, southeast, right? So this is Antelope Flat Development. I'm going to use a different color pen, because I'm going to go through and split this up. And so there may be, you know, when you go through and pull a legal description, the legal descriptions are gonna say, hey, this is section 27, and then they'll go through and will include some details along those lines and tell you how many acres are involved and property ownership and other types of information as well too. With this is a kind of a complicated development because it spills over into another section. And so that information for that section is going to be included as well as combined amounts for acreages. So it gets kind of complicated, but it's kind of like doing a little bit of a detective, work. But it is kind of fun to, township and ranger is kind of fun to go through and read these things and kind of tease out all the details. But I think I've given you enough information here to where you can kind of go through and figure out some of this stuff on your own.